Good day, everyone. So now we're here to interview one of the best artists in Cebu, no? Na daghan napadala o napakita sa mga festivals na mga fashion designs. So we have here Sir JB, and we will talk about his, what influenced him as well as some issues regarding art. So we have here Sir JB. Say hi!
Hi, everyone. My name.
So, sir, our first question would be, what influenced you in creating art?
I am from a family of artists, so I have so many influences in terms of art, but the one that is close to me now is fashion designing, and I believe I got that from my two grandparents, my grandmothers, my grandmothers, from the mother's side and the father's side. So they're both mananais, we call them sastres. And it runs in the blood, but unfortunately, I didn't get the chance to have a formal one-on-one and teaching with both my grandparents because they died before I discovered that I love fashion design.
But regarding your influences, you have mentioned that you focused on fashion design, but you also tried doing the traditional painting and other...
Yeah, I've tried, especially during my younger years, now back when I was still studying, where you will be forced to do artwork such as painting, collage, and especially in terms of submission with outputs in school. I love doing it, but for me, there is something lacking because I want to create a mark, a trademark, wherein it is something close to me, and it is something I won't find it hard to do, and something which I can influence others to do also the same.
Wow, that's great. I believe, sir, now your grandmothers are very proud of you, no? Asa na panabot, right? Like a legend, sir. And we're also happy that you're sharing this one to us. And yes, sir.
Regarding your influences, you have mentioned that you focused on fashion design, but you also tried doing the traditional painting and other...
Yeah, I've tried, especially during my younger years, now back when I was still studying. I keep on staying in a place where my lola in the father's side would use to tahi our school uniforms. He's our mananahe in our school uniforms back when I was still studying. And I will always get the retazos, but there's some retazos also falling from the sewing machines. And out from those retazos, I create stuff. I do not know what those are, but I feel like I am able to create a form. And out from it, imagination sprout. And then that's when I realized also that what I'm doing is something that can make me a better person, because it's not just doing art but also recycling, you know, upcycling, I mean, and then in such a way, I feel pa na ko na there is a connection between me and my lola, and I don't know why, but it was when they passed away that I realized when I missed them, that's when I come to a realization that I have to go back to the thing that I love, which has a connection with my family. And then I have been sketching fashion sketches. My ideas are actually transported into drawings, but only up until there. Ito lang yung pinag-sa drawing. No, it was when I finished college that I decided to pursue fashion stuff, to get a formal education in fashion design. So I enrolled in the one I used to be in MPP, because aside from it's free, it also is very near my place. So that's when I enrolled. It's a 6-month course for me to have a formal background of fashion designing, fashion constructing. And then there, from that moment, I decided take risks, join competitions, and luckily there are competitions I won, and there are also competitions wherein I failed to get the award.
So among all sa mga, you have mentioned, sir, the wins and the losses. So among all the wins, what is your most proud of? Yes.
Just recently, it's the second time actually that I have to compete internationally for a national costume competition wherein a Philippine representative was sent to an international stage to compete. I was assigned to create a national costume and in 2023 during the Mr. Pageant International held in Thailand, my design worn by Vince Drexel Tutut of the Philippines won Best National Costume. The design actually is inspired from my childhood.
So you will talk regarding what are your inspirations as well as the subjects later also. Yeah, he won the international competition to Gaisanya, the Oxas National Costume. I think that was in Thailand, no?
Yes.
And so now, waiting on that one, sir. So what are the subjects na ganahanin mo i-show sa mga fashion designs?
I'm very happy that there is a trend now wherein people use different transitions to highlight Philippinism, Philippine conceptualism. Okay, I'm so happy about that because with the question, I would relate it to the trend, the Believing More Filipinas trend, because most of my artworks are actually focused on Philippine iconography. So I want to highlight the rich culture that we have in the Philippines, the traditions that we have, and most importantly, the values that Filipinos have. So if we are to talk about the design, the winning design, which was held in Thailand, I call it actually Pagmalaki Mo.
But that was about like your childhood place,
yes.
You know?
My childhood experience.
That's really nice. So katong talan, sir, nasabot to incorporate in one.
Yes, one portion is one ensemble, and I'm very happy because it was highlighted, you know, and among 20 plus candidates, my piece was appreciated, and I would love to also the new generations to know that the 90s kids were happy even before the arrival of technology, the modernization that we have, which we will talk about later.
Yeah. Okay, so next one, sir.
Yeah.
What are the mediums, or we could say in the fashion design, the materials that you actually use or basi na kay imong own craft for this one? So yeah, mediums and materials.
I actually wanted to promote local materials because the sense of creating national costume for me is to promote the natural materials that we have. So in creating and inserting a piece, a national costume, an art piece, it's very necessary to
first think of materials, the availability and the functionality of the materials.
And for my case, I love to experiment. And when I experiment materials, I as much as possible, see to it that it's durable. And because sometimes the problem with national costumes, you know, is one of the biggest problems faced by national costume designers, to be honest, is in terms of transporting the design. Sometimes what arrives is not anymore the actual shape, the actual piece that you have constructed, because naay mga guba in terms of transportation. That is why in choosing the materials, I have to see to it that the materials is long-lasting and durable, so that if there will be problems in transporting it, the design won't get affected easily.
So, moving forward, so we'll talk about your first exhibit,
yes.
As well as, is it like you joined it, or is it like you make you like, you cannot prepare, or okay, ang question on your day, kung sa'yo mo napilan, bro, some artists, dili mo apilang exhibit, they exhibit their own art. And what is the exhibit all about?
Prior to being here in UPI, I used to be a department adept teacher, a senior high school arts and design instructor. So a year ago, I spearheaded a fashion show at the same time, an exhibit, fashion exhibit, with my arts and design students. And during that time, we are trying to come up with a title of our fashion show, and with the suggestions of my students and collaborative effort, we've come up with Phil Couture, a reimagined Filipino clothing through the modern days.
Regarding your success, also we have, you know, the low part. So what are, as an artist, as a fashion designer, what are the issues that you have faced?
I think this does not only apply to me, most of my friends who are also fashion designers share common sentiments about the fast fashion, because most of our clients actually would easily compare our range or the prices that we give them to the prices that they see in online sites, like to be specific, like in Shopee, because we know that fast fashion are affordable, but they fail to recognize that custom fashion pieces are custom designed according to the likeness of and the request of our dear client. So it hurts to our part that they compare our prices to the prices that they see in the online world, because they don't realize that in fast fashion, manufacturers manufacture it in such a way that they produce it in a dinaghanay. So if dinaghanay siya, of course they can price it at a lower cost, because kausa naman nila yung trabaho. Unlike if it's customized, one fashion piece would take so much time, effort, and dedication, so that you'll be able to produce this art piece that wouldn't fit you, your complexion, your size, your tone, and your taste, of course. So that's one of the greatest problems that designers face, you know, aside from when you don't satisfy your client.
So yeah, regarding that's one of the fast fashion issue, no? But as you can see in the Philippines, it's as a whole, or being an artist, is it also a problem, like asking them I talk with the fine arts people, so they say, yeah, we have talked about regarding that one. Is it also an issue regarding your friend, as well as when you have started, sir? Now, is it an issue for you also as a hub on the future?
As for my case, it was never an issue because I am not a full-time fashion designer. So it's never an issue to me kung asa siya po mapunta, because I know for a fact that I can land in a teaching position. So practicing it, it has never been an issue, you know, kung asa dito pa do. Because moto siya na I know na padong dito sa teaching, because I am a teacher by nature. So ang ako lang is, while practicing it, I was really thinking na ginahan ko na ma-showcase akong works internationally. So while working, while improving my craft, that's what I'm thinking already. That is why you have to create channels where you have to make friends, you know, with the people in the industry. I even message people. Now, my first stint in Winning Filipinas, I designed the national costume worn by Negros Oriental. She's Janina Baro. And I was so happy because it was my first national stint. But I didn't get it, like, they contacted me, I contacted them, if they need costume designers. Because I was very eager that time to showcase my craft, because I know every year, my good, naipakita ko mga national costumes. So, ako nabutang sa akong mind na kaya man ako produce ng mga anak. Pero there is no chance of me na kaya ma-involve ko na ako. So, what I did is, I messaged the candidates. So, when Winning Filipinas released their list of official candidates back in 2022, I tried to identify kung asa dito ang approachable somehow, asa dito ang laki connection. And then, there's this candidate, nga niyang brother is a friend of mine. So, I told my friend, if naikaila yung sister mo, wala tayong national costume designer, and all the candidates na sila yung group chat. And then, yan ang mga mag-message siya dito sa group chat. And then, there's this candidate, si from Negros Oriental, Janina Varro, wala pa siyang national costume designer. So she approached me, no? And then deals were closed, kung saan ang meron siya. And of course, ikaw may ni-offer, of course, you have to adjust. Nadilip ka mo price and ako kaayo. And sometimes, it still happens. Like, I'll work on your national costume and just provide me with the following.
Moving forward to regarding traditional arts have mentioned, so advent as a future for the present. So we will talk about like making designs very hard. It requires dedication, as you have mentioned, as well as time. But right now, one click could have a design right away. But of course, may inconsistencies. So what are your insights regarding AI art in terms or in context of fashion design?
Alright, before I speak whether I'm in favor of the rise of AI or I'm not in favor of it, I'd like to share that in one of the judging stints that I have attended, specifically in Inayawa National High School, I have talked to a graphic designer and we were sharing ideas regarding the rise of AI. And as I was listening to him, I realized that AI has been helping them because clients, whether we like it or not, AI, as what you mentioned, can do designs in just one snap. Okay. And if we talk about the designer I have spoken, ang yanggiling mo, dali ko kayo pag-approve sa client if they incorporate AI in their design. Because most of the clients would love AI designs, AI-ready designs, you know. So, if ganahan ang client ato, that's when they execute it, and then less hassle for them in terms of designing. But as for me, your design, your skills is still corrupted already. Mm-hmm. So, I'm not saying I'm not in favor of AI in that sense, but you are losing your sense of artistry. But if AI has been helping fashion designers, I'd say yes, also, in inspirations.
Yeah.
But we only use it as inspirations. If there are designs our clients would present to us, there are actually, it's happening. Clients would go to you and present their inspirations, and those are AI-generated designs. But I always tell them, I have to make my own design out from your design. So AI then has just been an inspiration and not overtaking my artistry. In my fashion design class here in UP, the first thing I did actually is to compare fashion pieces and costume. Okay. There should be a fine line between costume and fashion pieces. So to answer your question about how to incorporate social issue in my field, I'd have to say it would be easy for me if I incorporated the costumes and not the fashion pieces, because I don't want my clients to be wearing my fashion pieces in such a way that people would judge them as this and that, because different people have different views. Okay, but in the field of costuming, I would highly use that platform in raising awareness to a certain issue close to me, social issue close to me, because costumes are intended to be something, to be presented in such a way that there is a hidden message out there. There is an understatement, a statement you want to present, but you want to hide, you see? So, in costuming, it's very easy for me to express how I feel because I'm limited in terms of the size, could be, you know, the color, you know, the weight, and the structure, the silhouette. So in addressing an issue, it would be easy for me if I can share costume. I haven't tried that, but I will try that.